Continuing in this vein of wonder, we have Robert-Houdin. This is the gentleman who revealed the defecating duck to be a fake. So he did many things. Not only was he an incredible clockmaker and magician and also invented the mystery clock, he actually was hired by the French government to put down a rebellion. So his magic was so good, they hired him to go out and pretend to be a sorcerer, and he basically saved France. So not many clockmakers can put that on their CV. What's most interesting is the fact that Robert-Houdin was the son of a watchmaker and had planned to be a watchmaker, but actually went to law school. And while he went to a bookshop to collect a two-volume set on law, he was mistakenly given a two-volume set on magic. And the world was never the same. He ended up moving into Paris and marrying the daughter of a prominent clockmaker, and his time there really redid magic. He's considered the father of modern magic and was the first magician to incorporate mechanical devices and clocks using electricity into his shows, which was definitely a result of his work as a clockmaker. So not only did Houdin inspire a lot of firms to actually go on and develop other mystery clocks, but he also inspired the very famous Russian goldsmith Peter Carl Fabergé. So Fabergé was the goldsmith to the Tsar, Nicholas II, and took much of his inspiration from masterworks of the past. So this is his version of the Houdin orange tree. This is known as the bay tree egg. This is from 1911. So instead of having the handkerchief that carries this piece with the butterflies, it actually has a singing bird in the center, which is also a homage to Jacques Edros, who invented the singing bird. Here is none other than his tiny silver swan automaton. This actually came in another one of his beautiful eggs. He actually had 52 of these eggs that were created by Fabergé for the Tsar Nicholas II. He had a standing order of two of these every year, so there was one for his mother and one for his wife. This beautiful egg has matte lilac enamel. It has this swan that sits in a bed of aquamarine with all these beautiful little flowers. What's probably the most surprising thing about this mechanical swan is the fact that it is actually made of gold and then plated in silver. How's that for an Easter present? And this is from the year 1906. When Peter Carl took over his father's firm, there was definitely this move from producing jewelry to producing kind of artist jeweler type objects. So this particular one was the peacock egg. Don't know if I mentioned this, but his mother got all of the mechanical ones. So this was this beautiful peacock that certainly had to have been influenced by another older artwork. Since the Fabergé firm was actually also the keepers of the objects inside the Hermitage, they looked after and repaired many of the objects within the collection there. This allowed Fabergé to go and study all of these older pieces and build replicas and different pieces that would pay homage to these masterworks of the past.